Inyo County is facing placement on the state's watch list while still trying to make progress on the enforcement of COVID-19 health orders. There's been an almost fatalistic exception that, after the recent 4 deaths at the local nursing care center in Bishop, that most likely Inyo County can't avoid fate when it comes to being placed on that state watch list. But it turns out that the county is getting a bit of a reprieve thanks to the state's coronavirus data tracking system. The California Reportable Disease Information Exchange, nicknamed, I guess, CalReady, which the state has relied upon in making decisions on who should be placed on the watch list, well, it has some kind of a data problem. And if you're a data software program, that's a real problem. So anyway, the state health officials admitted to this problem on Wednesday, August 15th. Because of the data issue, they have had to stop removing or adding to a list of counties that faced more restrictions on businesses, indoor gatherings and activities, and schools until it's fixed. Currently, 38 of 58 counties in the state are on that list, with all major counties already on it. However, this brief stay does not mean that Inyo County is out of the woods and will dodge eventually being placed on that list once the problem is resolved. According to the Centers for Disease Control, as of Thursday, August 13th, California still has the greatest number of reported positive coronavirus cases in the county. Keep in mind that according to health officials in California, the true number of cases is even higher than what the reporting system was recording. There is always a delay between the time a death occurs and the time it is reported to the state. Credibility is crucial to public health officials in keeping the public's trust and cooperation. Nationally, the numbers of positive coronavirus cases are now at 5,321,472, and that's up over 65,544 from yesterday, and 168,910 plus 1,049 deaths as of Thursday, August 13th. So 1,549 deaths a day. The U.S. is currently continuing to lead the rest of the entire world in the number of positive COVID-19 cases and deaths, and that doesn't look like it is about to change. California's CalReady system uses data from testing labs around the state, which counties might land on the county's or state's watch list. To come off the list, a listed county must wait for 14 days, and it can then begin to reopen activities and reopen certain businesses or offer in-person classroom instruction. The Inyo County Health Department has apparently ramped up its efforts over the last few weeks to bring non-compliant businesses in line with health orders. In fact, they successfully had a temporary restraining order against Two Brothers of Italy in Big Pine in court on Wednesday, August 12th. And the pizza place is now closed until it complies with county health orders. Inyo County CAO Clint Quilter earlier in the week had explained the county's process. He stated that the county will not be dealing with the issue through or based on social media, but rather a process that involves the county first sending an official letter to a non-compliant business and working with the business to bring it into compliance. Quilter noted that thanks to hardworking and dedicated county employees, their efforts have already had some real results with the successful temporary restraining order against Two Brothers from Italy, which should send a strong signal to others who are not in compliance with COVID-19 health orders. Well, this is kind of sad, but The 2020 Tri-County Fair has been canceled, and it really didn't come as a surprise, says the CEO. CEO Jen McGuire discussed how the Inyo County Public Health Department believed it would not be in the best interest of the county fair to host it this year due to the state of California not allowing any mass gatherings. McGuire also says that she has tried to find a solution when it comes to hosting the fair, but it just is not possible. She says, "We have tried different ideas, and I have laid awake each night to see if we can do a virtual fair or an open market or anything possible to try and make it work. Unfortunately, it is just not going to happen with the numbers of COVID cases rising and expected to rise over the next few weeks." She said that, "I have to tell you, canceling the fair was something that we all kind of knew was coming, but it is still just sad that it's actually happening. We have tried everything we possibly could to make it happen."